go to any freezer in our lab and...
Get ready. It's quite a sight.
You will find just tons and tons of poop. This is cougar. These are whales. So here's all the killer whale projects. Mount St. Helens from elk. And we've got, you know, oodles and oodles of poop.
Samuel Wasser's Center for Conservation Biology at the University of Washington has studied hundreds of animals over the years, but it is his pioneering research of elephant DNA that has attracted international acclaim.
So African elephants are now being poached at a rate of about 40,000 animals a year, and there's only 400,000 elephants left in Africa.
His lab uses DNA to trace the origin and shipment of illegal ivory. This has been a tremendous breakthrough in helping bring poachers to justice.
Oh, here's some elephant dung. So this is the DNA extracts from the dung from South Sudan, Kenya, as well as DNA from ivory. So
the first step is extracting DNA from dung samples.
Removing all the leaves and the extra liquid and getting the solid part, basically, which is going to be later extracted.
We would get samples from across the continent, from ourselves collecting or colleagues, and created a DNA map of elephant genetics for the entire continent of Africa, one for forest elephants and one for savanna elephants. Once we had that map, we then developed ways to get DNA from ivory, and we could get a large seizure and genotype all those samples, match their genotypes to the map, and then tell where the elephant actually was poached.
The ivory samples are little squares that look like pieces of ceramic tile.
You know, this is kind of a typical piece of ivory. We cut it from the base of the tusk because it's the richest in DNA.
Extracting DNA from ivory is a painstakingly detailed process. Each step is carefully documented so the information can be used as evidence to prosecute ivory poachers and exporters.
So here are examples. Once there's a large seizure and that seizure arrives in our lab, it takes us a total of 3 weeks to get the entire seizure analyzed, assign for origin, and to write a full report and send it back to the country that sent it to us. Our work was instrumental in bringing down probably the biggest ivory dealer in Africa, and we had linked them to 10 major ivory seizures with DNA.
And so here, I'm just going to show you in a second after I open it peacefully, you can see the liquid on one side of the tube and the precipitate on the other side.
To measure the effect that humans have on threatened and endangered species, the Center for Conservation Biology analyzes a scat of many other animals.
Wolves, caribou, moose, deer, coyotes, cougars, bobcat, bears, the list goes on.
The scat from these animals is smaller and more difficult to find than elephant dung, so the center has specially trained dogs called conservation canines. Some of these canines can sniff out whale feces on the water. Others are trained to detect scat from wolves and other carnivores.
Just for our wolf study alone, we will get 5,000 samples for that one study of dung.
Wasser loves all animals, but his work with elephants holds a special place because he feels that the center's work is making a difference. He wants to make sure that future generations can appreciate what he's seen.
You know, there's nothing more wonderful than to go to Africa and see these wildlife and to just appreciate their splendor.